Hello everybody! Welcome to Dayton Children's Community Teaching Kitchen. I've been so lonely without people coming in for classes that I thought I would make a video and we could cook together at home. So today we're going to make some tacos with veggies and beans. We're going to make our very own taco seasoning and we're going to put it on top of rice. So before we start cooking, we got to wash our hands. Come join me over by the sink. Alright, turn on the water, grab some soap. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Emily. Happy birthday to you. All right, all set. Let's go back to cooking. So today, I'm gonna use gloves when I cook, but I'm only doing this because I'm not cooking at home. If I was at home, washing my hands would be sufficient. We wanna wash our hands before we start every time, and then in between things like handling meat, which we're gonna use today. So what I'm gonna do once I get these gloves on, it's a little tricky because of the water, is I'm gonna start our meat because that's gonna take a little while to cook all the way through. Today we're using ground beef. We're using this because this is what I had in the freezer. At home, you could use something like ground turkey, you could use beans, you could use tofu. Anything that sounds good to you is totally fine. Tacos are very versatile. You can throw in anything that you have in your pantry. So I'm gonna turn this up to about medium-high heat. Open this up and let it start cooking. And then, because I just touched meat, I'm actually going to change my gloves and wash my hands again. All right, so this right here, what we have is a homemade taco seasoning. So perhaps if you couldn't find any taco seasoning at the grocery store, or you just wanna use what from the seasonings that you have at home, this is awesome. This is a no salt taco seasoning. That's something that we can add later on. But salt's always something we want to think about, and so the less we add initially is better. So the link for, there will be a description of the taco seasoning in the description of the video, so you can always go back to that. But we'll get started with 2 teaspoons of chili powder. So I have my teaspoon measuring spoon here. If you had any little guys at home with you who wanted to cook, this would be a great job for them. We have 1/4 teaspoon of garlic powder. We are actually almost all out of garlic powder, so I'm just gonna put it all in there. 1/4 teaspoon of onion powder. You know what? We're almost out of onion powder too. So I'm gonna put it all in there. 1/4 teaspoon of oregano. There we go. 1/2 teaspoon of paprika. And 1/2 teaspoon of pepper. Go. And 1.5 teaspoons of ground cumin. Now, if there are any seasonings in this mixture that aren't your favorite, by all means, take them out. If there's something that you think this is missing, then put it in. With cooking, there are very few rules, and making things to taste that you enjoy, by all means, you should do it. So all our seasonings are in there. I'm gonna give it a stir. And this is good for about 1 pound of meat or kind of whatever mixture you're using today. So we'll use probably most of this for our recipe today. And you can hear our beef sizzling, so I'm gonna start breaking that up. So we're coming in for, this is our beef starting to cook. So I'm just breaking this up, letting it as much of it to hit the pan as we can. With taco meat, or with any type of ground beef like this. We just want it, all the pink color to go away. So we're gonna let this keep cooking. I'll keep stirring it around every now and then to keep it moving. Something else that we're doing is our rice is starting here. So I'm letting the water boil. Today I'm just using instant brown rice because that's just what we had in our cabinet, but you can use anything. You can use white rice, you can use regular rice, tortillas. If you had nacho chips at home, you could do that as well. Use whatever's available to you, whatever's in your pantry. While I'm waiting for my meat to cook, the next thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna drain our black beans. Black beans are a great source of fiber and protein, and they're a great way to stretch any meal that you have as well. So I'm gonna drain and rinse these beans, and then we'll add them in once the beef is all cooked. This is a great job for a little one at home if you have one. Good to go. It looks like our water's boiling already, so I'm gonna go ahead and add our rice. For instant brown rice, it's a 1-to-1 ratio, so we have about 3/4 cup of rice. There's 3/4 cup of water. I'm just gonna put that in, stir it up a little bit, and then turn it down, and it'll be ready in about 10 minutes. All right, so our meat is cooked all the way through. You can tell there's no pink bits at any part of the pan. And we've broken up all the big bits, so we know that it's cooked all the way through. So what I'm gonna do is add our vegetables in and get those cooked all the way through. Today what I have is just some summer squash that I've frozen a couple weeks ago to be used. Summer squash, zucchini, they all have a very mild flavor, so it's a great addition to add to almost any meal because they'll very much take on the flavor of what you put in it. And then the next thing that I have are some peppers and onions. So this is one of those dollar bags that you can get at the grocery store of frozen veggies. Everything's already cut up, so it's very convenient. And in the winter especially, these can be a much better buy than buying the peppers and onions yourself. So it's convenient, it's very cost effective, and right now, since it's in the freezer, it has a long shelf life, and that can be really convenient for the times that we're in right now. So I'm gonna add these in and let them cook down. Now, whenever you're using frozen vegetables, you will see more water come out as they're cooking through. That's totally normal. We're just gonna let some of that water cook out. So I'll break it up. And I'm actually gonna add my seasoning right now as well. So I'll add it on top. I'll save a little bit for the end. I'll break it up, stir it, and we'll keep going. So while this is cooking, let's talk about cooking with little ones at home. Right now, your kids have more time than ever, and you might have more time than you ever had before since most of us are inside. So right now, taking the time to learn how to cook and cooking together, there's no better time. So let's talk about the different age groups. If, let's say you have an infant at home and maybe they're starting to explore new foods, what would be really cool right now is put them in your baby Bjorn or just grab them in your arms, and while you're stirring and looking at the different things, just have them in your arms and let them smell and look and explore those new sights, the new smells that they can see, and that can get them interested in trying some new foods. So that would be a great thing for infants. Say you have a toddler at home, something that is great for your kitchen is buy them something like this stool. So this is a foldable stool. I'm not gonna open it, but this is a foldable stool. It was about $10 to $15 on Amazon. They can ship it right to your house. I've also seen them at many like major retailers, and you can put this right next to wherever you're cooking. So this is great. They can, if it was a toddler or preschool age, they can help you measure out the spices. They can stir the ingredients. You wanna warn them to be careful about different parts on the stove. So one thing that I'll talk about is with your writing hand, you hold the spatula, and with your other hand, you hold the pan. And that makes, that way their hands will stay away from the hot stove. But let them stir, let them add things in. They'll be really great at that. for school age kids, especially as they get older, if you are chopping any of the vegetables themselves, you could get them started with an easy vegetable. Of course, they can watch the stove and watch for things as they cook. They can, of course, stir and add all those ingredients in as well. And they can also play a part in planning your meals. So as you're making your grocery list, what kind of meals do they like? What kinds of recipes do they want to try? Let them contribute to that. And then finally, for high school age kids, they should be able to make all of this themselves. So give them a recipe, go sit down on the couch, and let them make dinner for you. All right, so we're all done. I plated our meal. If you look at our bowl here, I have some of our taco meat and vegetables, some brown rice, and I had a little bit of avocado in my fridge for us to eat with it. If you wanted to top this with cheese or salsa, all of those would go really well with this. So I'm gonna take a bite, I'm gonna let you know how it tastes, and then if you make it at home, go ahead and let us know how it tastes and how everything turned out. Get a little bit of everything on my fork. That is a great lunch or dinner meal. If you were to save any food, if you had any leftovers, you can keep it in the fridge for about 3 days. Try to eat it within 3 days. This also would freeze very well. So put it in a container, freeze it for about 3 months, up to 3 months, and you'll be good to go. Thank you so much for watching this video. We'll be posting more of these. Let us know how anything turned out, and I'll see you in the future. Thanks so much.